Good morning. Happy Thursday. Today, I did 90 minutes of yoga, and then I went on to do about 55 minutes of meditation in our clear light sauna. So it got me thinking about some things that I want to share with you guys today, because this morning I woke up, you might be able to hear it in my voice today, but I woke up kind of with a stuffy, runny nose and a sore throat and just not feeling the best. So I made the decision today, instead of feeling like crap, that I was going to experience life and take care of myself. So that's why I spent extra time this morning doing the yoga, doing the meditation. And it brings me to this moment right now where I want to share something with you about your emotions and about your feelings, okay? So I'm gonna teach you guys, help you guys by having you answer four questions for yourself, but I just wanna talk about feelings and emotions just a little bit. Now, I've had a lot of experience in my life facing certain things that I'm feeling and dealing with them in a different way than what I'm actually feeling. And what I mean by that is, thinking back multiple times, I've been able to share and speak on a stage in front of 8,000 plus people in a workshop or at a conference. Now, when I'm behind the curtain and it's the hour before, I remember the first time I had to use the restroom like 8 times. My hands and my palms are sweaty. My heartbeat is up. Like, all of these feelings I experienced in the beginning, but I still experience those feelings, like my heart racing, my palms getting sweaty, kind of a nervous anxiety. And I feel those things, right? Those come out of me. But what you can do with emotions is, what happens is we define them as, oh no, I'm frightened, I'm scared, I'm nervous. All of these things, we define those emotions. But here's the thing, you can define those emotions in a different way, those things that you're feeling. So for example, here's another cool thing. When I'm super excited to do something, when I'm, let's say I'm fishing and I hook a big fish and I'm excited, my heart rate raises, my palms get sweaty, and I start breathing a little faster. The exact same thing when I'm extremely excited happens when I'm fishing, and the same things happen inside of my body when I'm about to speak. So what I'm gonna teach you guys is that when I go on to speak, or maybe you are going to do a sales call, a prospect call, have a hard conversation, you're feeling those things, you can define it differently so that you can experience it at a different level. So I define those moments when I'm about to go on a stage in front of 8,000 people as I'm feeling excited. So when I'm behind there, behind the curtain, about ready to come out, previously I'd say, oh, I'm nervous, I'm scared, am I gonna do okay? Now I feel those things, my hands are shaking, my heart rate's up, I'm breathing faster. I say, hey, I'm excited. I get to go out there and I get to share a message and I get to share my heart and I get to impact people in a very positive way, and I'm excited about that. And it changes the whole experience. Now here's the thing, every single day you experience feelings like anger, frustration, hurt, betrayal, loss, love. You sense all of these different things. These emotions come up inside of us. But here's what you can do. You can give new meaning to those feelings every single day. So I'm gonna give you guys just a quick example. So maybe sitting down to do homework with I have 5 kids, so sitting down with your kids to do homework can feel frustrating sometimes, or they don't sit still and it takes longer than it should take. So in that type of experience, in that moment, you could be like, oh, this is frustrating. Why don't they listen? Why don't they just sit down and do it? You could look at it a whole different way. And before you go into doing the homework with your child in this moment, you could say, you could ask questions like, what do I want to feel when I'm helping my daughter? Or you could say, what feeling do I want them to have about me? What feeling do I want them to have about the homework itself, about sitting down and accomplishing something? What kind of feelings do I want my child to have about life in general? So instead of just going into homework with that dread or whatever that feeling is, you could go into it by asking those questions about what you want the outcome to be. So guys, here are some things that are gonna help you become better with dealing with your emotions every single day of your life, whether it's in parenting, at your job, because I know many of you guys have gotten to work and you're just like, oh my gosh, another day in paradise, and you're complaining about this person is always making you so mad or angry, or this person's always doing this. So here's 4 questions that I want you guys to write down. I want you to ask for yourself. Number one, the emotions that I have been experiencing lately are. It's going to be so important that you learn how to identify the emotions that you are actually feeling and experiencing. So the emotions that I have been experiencing lately are, you're going to write that down. Number two, you're going to say, what area of my life am I having the feelings that I want to? So what area of my life am I not having the feelings in my life that I want to? Okay, number three is the feelings I want to experience more of in this life are. And then the fourth one is the next time I feel a negative emotion come up out of me, the thing I'm going to tell myself or say to myself is this. Okay, so we're gonna recap that real quick. The emotions I've been experiencing a lot lately are, and that could be frustration, anger, no self-worth, low self-esteem, whatever it is, that's what you're gonna answer first. Number two, the area of my life I am not having the feelings that I would like to have are, so what part of your life, what area, is it in your work, is it in your relationship, is it in your own self-belief? Number three, the feelings I want to experience more in this life are, that kind of goes back to the example I gave you of the child doing the homework. I want to experience the feeling of creating love and happiness inside of my home. Or if you're doing a sales call, it could be like, what if they say no? What if they reject me? What if I don't do good? What if I stumble on my words? You could, in that instance, say the feeling I want to experience more in my life, in my career, when I am making a connection with someone and selling something is I want to feel a genuine connection and a genuine building of a friendship between me and that person. I want to really understand and feel the pains and struggles that my client has been going through so that I can best know how to serve them with excellence. Okay, so define the feelings you want to experience more in those areas of your life. And the last one again, the next time I feel a negative emotion come up inside of me, the thing I'm gonna tell myself is this. Okay, those are the four questions that I know if you can begin to answer for yourself, you'll be able to have more control over what you're feeling each day, no matter what happens throughout your day. Guys, I love you guys. Have an incredible and blessed Thursday. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace.